Okay, so let us go with the next program. Now this program says that you are going to type the string of characters from the keyboard. Okay, so you are going to type the string of characters from the keyboard by using DOS interrupt function. Okay, DOS interrupt function is the main thing. All these programs, all these two programs which I am explaining to you is related to the DOS interrupt related programs, right? So now how many number of characters I am going to type from the keyboard? That is very important. Now you keep on typing infinite times? No. You need to type some number of characters on the keyboard, and it should stop after typing that number of characters. Your processor should not allow you to type some more characters, right? So for that, I am defining this value as 20. Okay, so 20 characters I am going to type from the keyboard. So that is what I am doing here. Now I'll just tell you what is this all being given here. So just think that this 20 is the number of characters I am going to type from the keyboard. And when I type from the keyboard, I should have 20 different spaces so that I can store that particular value which I am trying to type from the keyboard. Right? So that is what this 20, whatever you can see here. Okay? So it says question mark because you haven't typed anything from the keyboard, right? So we don't know what is getting stored. So once you type, the 20 memory is defined to get stored the value whatever you are typing from the keyboard. Therefore, it is ready to get stored. Means that is what you are defining a memory for the particular 20 characters what you are typing. That's it. Okay, from this particular. Now the main program starts from this code segment. Here, read procedure is being written and display procedure is being written. Then my program starts from this line. So initializing the data segment has been done here. So this is the line where my actual program will start for this particular program. Now you might ask me the question, sir, where we can put the procedure block? Procedure program can be written anywhere I want in the program? No. Procedure, whatever you try to write, right? So this procedure program should not be written after data segment and before assume at all. It should be written after assume. All procedure related programs should always be written after assume, or else you can also write all the procedure programs after this in 21H you can write the procedure programs, or after assume before stat you can add the procedure program. These are the only two ways where you can write procedure programs in your program. You can't just say that, sir, after data segment, before this code segment, can I write all the procedure programs what we do in C program. In C program you can either declare global function or local function. Function is equal to procedure in your 8086. Okay, so there local, global is allowed, but here it should always be a local. You can't go with global. Understood? Now, here I am going to load DX with the offset of BUF. This is equal to, this instruction is similar to LDA DX comma BUF. Now this is one Viva question which you can get in the exam. How do you replace LEA with MOV? How load effective address instruction can be written by using a MOV instruction? Means both should do the same job. Okay? When I am using MOV instruction, I see to that I use this offset one. Understood? So when I say MOV DX comma offset BUF, means what? The address of that is getting stored to DX. So it is similar to LEA DX comma BUF. You don't need offset here because LEA itself says it is an offset address that you are going to try to load to DX. Now why am I going to load into DX? It should be always in DX. I hope you remember the message display program we wrote, right? In our lab we wrote message display program, right? What we wrote, that three lines, move DX comma message, move AH comma 09 in 21. I told you, whenever you are displaying any message, you see through that the address of the particular message should be present in DX register always. Here, I am typing string of characters. If you take the entire characters of the string, what it is? It is nothing but a message, right? Yes or no? If I say Bangalore Institute of Technology, for example. Can it be a message? See, message means what? It's a group of characters which says it is a string. A string can be also a message, right? So here I am trying to type from the keyboard and I am allowed only to type 20 characters in this program because the size I have given in the data segment is 20. When I am typing something 20 characters, the group of characters is nothing but a string, and that group of characters which is a string can also be a message. Therefore here I have to load to DX always. The offset of buffer should always be loaded to DX, and you cannot use any other register. Keep this in mind. Okay. But after loading the offset address to DX, I am going to call the particular procedure reads. Okay. Now what is that reads is doing? That reads is, read means what? You are trying to type something from the keyboard. Right? That is what read. You type and you read from the keyboard on the display unit, right? So that is what. So I am trying to call reads. So let me see the particular control will jump here. It is procedure, not macro. Therefore, it jumps there and it tries to execute whatever it is written in the procedure block. Now, what I have written? 0A is very important. 0A is the function number which allows you to type more than one character. Which is the function that allowed you to type only one character? Last program with echo and without echo. 01 is also a function number which allows you to type one character. 08 is also a function number which allows you to type one character. 06 and 07 is also allows you to type one character. Understood? But here, when I am using 0A, it means that it is allowing you to type more than one character. Okay? Now, more than one character, you just can't just say that you can keep on typing some characters on the dashboard. You should see through that where I need to stop. That is the reason why I have given the counter 20 here. Okay? So, I keep on typing till the 20 characters is being reached. Once I type that, I am going to return. So, once I return, I will come back here. Okay? I will come back here and then I will say move DL, 0AH, move AH, 0 to H, and in 21H, and then move DL, 0 to H. See, this 3 line and this 3 line, they are all grouped together by the processor point of view. It says that carriage return. Okay? So carriage return means what? Means that is where your processor thinks that is the end of the string. Means that is where I need to stop. Okay? So that is where I need to stop and I need to go to the new line. Got it? So to do that process, you need to send carriage return will go with two values. One is 0A, 0DH. A means what? 10 in decimal. 0D is what? 13. 13 in decimal. 10, 13 are the two values which is equal to slash n in your program. See. What is slash n will do? Yeah, you go to the new line, right? It means that it says that is the end of that particular string I am going to type. Okay? Now, after that, my job is to send the dollar. Okay? The dollar symbol says what? Means the dollar again defines that that is the end of your line. Means that is the character which is ended in that line. And you are pointing out to the new line. Okay? But after that particular character at last, what you see? You are not going to consider any of the memory after that particular dollar symbol. Okay, so that is what it says. Now here, to send the dollar symbol, I can't send dollar symbol however I want. Where I need to send the dollar symbol? I need to send at the end, right? I cannot send it in the beginning. So I need to send that dollar at the end. So for that, what I will do? Again, I will take the offset of that particular buffer to DX. So offset of buffer is what? 0000, right? Offset of the buffer is what? 0, 0, 0. I will take that to BX and then I will say AL comma BX plus 1. So AL is equal to what? 0, 0, 0, 1. Add AL with 2. So what is AL now? AL only BX plus 1. BX plus 1 means whatever the value what is present in 0, 0, 0, 1 that will be loaded to AL. Now what is there in BX plus 1 here? So, see here, this buffer DB20, right? That is what buffer is all. What is buffer plus 1? It goes to the next line on 1 because this is 1 byte. This is 1 byte. There is no any other byte there. Therefore, this entire line is on 1 byte. If I say buffer plus 1, it means that it is going to the next line, right? Means this is the next memory. So, this 20 will be stored in 0, 0, 0, 0, whereas 0 gets stored in 0, 0, 0, 1 and that 0 will be loaded to AL. So AL will be 0. Understood? After loading AL with 0, I am adding AL with 2. Therefore AL will become 2. I am XORing H with H. Right? What is the reason XORing H with H? So I XOR H with H only to see through that whether I have reached to the end of that particular string. Understood? As H will have the content of whatever the content I am going to type from the keyboard, right? So H will be XORed with H such that I am actually, means XOR is what? Clearing the register, that's it. Okay? XORing is nothing but clearing the register. Either you say move H, 0, 0, or you can say XOR H, H. Okay? Now, what is the XOR operation? 1 XOR with 1 is what? 0. 0 XOR with 1 what? 1. Now, when I say XOR H, H, you are XORing with the same values, right? For example, H 8 and 1 0 0 0 XOR with 1 0 0 0. Now what is the result? 0. So XOR operation is used for what? Either you say move H, 0, or you can say XOR H, H, one and the same. Okay? So you are clearing H register here. Then I am saying move SI, AX. Now what was AX here? AH is 0, 1. AH is 0. What is AL? 0, 2. What is AX now? AH is 0, 0. AL is 0, 2. Therefore, AX is 0, 0, 0, 2. Therefore, I am going to put that 0, 0, 0 to SI. Okay? Therefore, SI will be equal to 0, 0, 0, 2 now. And then what I am doing here? I am going to load dollar to CH. And then I am saying, move bx plus si comma ch. Therefore bx was what? Bx was the option 0 0 0 0 and si is what? 0 0 0 2. 0 0 0 0 plus 0 0 0 2 is again 0 0 0 2. And to that memory location you are trying to push the content of ch, which is dollar. Dollar has been put to 0 0 0 2. And what is that 0002 is going to begin from? That is the destination where I need to point out. Right? So 002 is that is the destination where I need to point out. Therefore, there if I push dollar symbol, then it says that I am going to end. Means that is the string where I am going to consider. And if you miss that dollar to be sent, what happens, you know, the error what you get in the program is, your program goes to an infinite loop. Means it will not stop at all. It will not stop saying that you are not, means it says that you are not at the end, you are not till at the end. So it keeps on giving you some junk characters again and again and again. Because I don't have any counter here to make that particular program to stop. Am I having any counter here? Decrement CX n number of times so that it will display the character for that n number of times of CX getting decremented. Once CX becomes 0, that is the end. I don't have that counter here. So I should make somehow that particular typing of the characters on the keyboard to get stopped. So how can I stop? One thing is making that particular control to getting into the new line by using the carriage return 10, 30. The second thing is try to put a dollar symbol so that it will end that particular string there itself and it doesn't take anything in the new line. Means in the same line it doesn't take other than that particular 20 characters. But problem here is, this program will allow you to type only 19 characters. It will never allow you to type 20 characters. Have you seen it in the lab? The reason is, dollar will also take one space in that particular line. Hello? 0002 means what? It is one of the location where my destination is getting stored. Yes or no? See, 000 is getting stored with 20. 0001 is getting stored with 0. Where my 002 is getting started from? This is the line where 002 is getting started, right? Means that is the memory location where my destination is going to begin. Therefore, dollar is getting stored with that particular location, in that particular location. It means that 002, whatever the location is there, there you are going to store dollar. Therefore, that is also one of the location where my characters that I am trying to type is getting stored. Therefore, out of 20 characters, you will be able to type from the keyboard only 19 characters, where one of the characters will be dollar, which will not be visible on the dark screen. You can't see dollar on the dark screen. Okay? So, it is an inbuilt value that you are giving for a processor to stop. But visibility for you on the dark screen is only the character what you type. Dollar will not be visible. Okay? Therefore, this entire code from here, move a, real comma 0a, till this particular, move h comma 4ch into 21h, whatever you have, this entire values that you are giving in this program is all for the processor to get controlled, so that it will not go to infinite row, and meanwhile it will go to the new line by ending that line which you are going to type, which is 19 different characters, and plus 20 is plus dollar symbol ones. Okay, so this is what is required without typing a characters, group of characters which is a string from the keyboard. So carry return is very important. 0a, 0d, 10 comma 13. Similarly, this dollar is being sent. While all this line is sent and data only to make sure dollar will be sent to 002. Okay, that is very important. Directly you can't say that move dollar comma 002. That is not possible. That is the reason why we have written some 6 lines of code here. Okay. Display procedure. Display procedure is written because you need to display on the dark screen, right? See, you type something from the keyboard. It doesn't mean that it will display on the dark screen. You need to display it by having a display procedure. So once this display procedure has been executed, you will be able to see on the dark screen whatever you have typed. So for that, you need not to type Alt plus F5. I have used this move h comma 4ch and int 21h, right? That will directly terminate you to the dark screen. If these two lines is not there and if you have written in 3H, how will you see the output on the dark screen? You should type that Alt plus F5. Only then you can get into dark screen. But here, you can directly get into the dark screen. Otherwise, if you are running this program, what you do, right? Type TASM, type TLink, and then don't type TD. Just type file name and then press enter. It will allow you to type and you will be able to see what you are typing on the dark screen. Means that is how you run this program. You need not to get into debugger because you are not seeing the output on the debugger screen. You are directly looking into the task. Even with echo and without echo also, don't get into debugger screen. Type file, TASM, TLink, whatever you type as usual. The third instruction what you do, TD you give and you get into the debugger screen, right? Don't type TD. Just type file name and enter. And it will allow you to do whatever the input and the output, whatever you are trying to give, and you will be able to see that on the task screen itself.